Talha radiallahu anh was one of the heroes of Uhud. Even for the smallest thing, Abu Talha was among the companions who were willing to sacrifice his life for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which he believed to be the greatest blessing. In fact, he was famous for his devotion and affection to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abu Talha radiallahu anh was born in Medina and was married to a Muslim, and she was the reason he became a Muslim. A Muslim's first husband passed away before the hijrah, and the Muslim was widowed. She waited until her son Anas bin Malik grew up to get married again. Abu Talha had proposed to Muslim many times but was rejected. One day, Abu Talha once again visited her house, and when a Muslim saw that he insisted on marrying her, she had hope in him. She considered accepting the marriage to allow someone in the darkness to see the light of Islam. She told him, "Someone like you isn't someone to be rejected. However, you're a polytheist. If I were to marry you, would you genuinely be a believer in Islam, or would you hide your past way of belief? I am a Muslim, and I believe in Allah and His Messenger, peace be upon Him. I don't want money from you. I want you to be a Muslim. Don't you know that if you put the idol you worship as a god on fire, it would burn to ash? Aren't you ashamed to worship something like this? If you bear witness that there is no god but Allah and that Muhammad is His messenger, I will accept that as a dowry and will not ask for anything else." These words deeply affected him. Signs of faith began to appear on his face. He said, "I accept your offer. I testify that there is no god but Allah and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah to her." After their marriage, his life completely changed. He devoted all of himself and his life out to Islam. Rasulullah ﷺ established a brotherhood with Abu Talha radiallahu anh and had a close relationship with him and his wife. From time to time, Rasulullah ﷺ visited his family, and these visits made them very happy. Also, if a nice meal was cooked in their house, some of it would be saved for our Prophet. Abu Talha, as there was one of the wealthiest in the Ashab, had many date orchards in Medina. Among these, he liked the Bayraha orchard the most. This place was very close to Masjid Nabawi. Our Prophet ﷺ often visited here, watched his beautiful scenery, and drank orchard's famous spring water. Abu Talha made many sacrifices for Islam and our Prophet. He participated in all wars with our Prophet ﷺ and showed great heroism. In the Battle of Uhud, Abu Talha radiallahu anh shielded against those who wanted to kill our Prophet. Even though Allah was protecting our Prophet, he was still struggling to shield him. This effort shown by Abu Talha pleased our Prophet. One of the most obvious qualities of Abu Talha was his obedience to the orders of Allah and the Prophet. He would immediately fulfill what was ordered without questioning in any manner. This great Sahaba also narrated 92 hadiths. After the death of our Prophet ﷺ, Abu Talha was not able to stay with the memories of our Prophet and moved to Damascus from Medina. No matter how much he wanted to visit the grave of Messenger of Allah, he remained in Damascus for a long time. However, he returned to Medina in the last days of Umar radiallahu anh's caliphate. Umar radiallahu anh entrusted Abu Talha with the duty of guarding the door of the meeting during the process of deciding a new caliph. One day, Abu Talha radiallahu anh was reading a Quran. While reading, he saw the verse, "Go forth, whether light or heavy, and strive with your wealth and your lives in the cause of Allah. That is better for you, if you only knew." The verse arose the love of Shahada in him. Abu Talha radiallahu anh said, "This verse commands us to join the struggle, whether we are young or old. My children see my preparation, I'm going out and defending my religion." Abu Talha radiallahu anh was 70 years old at the time. His children did not accept this request and said, "Allah bless you. You have been in every war with Allah's Rasul until he passed away. You have also participated in battles in the time of Abu Bakr radiallahu anh and Umar radiallahu anh. Now let us do it for you." Abu Talha insisted on joining the battle. Finally, he participated in the army. But while he was on a warship, he surrendered his soul. Because they were at the sea, they could not find a place to bury him for 7 days. Although he stayed so long, his body was not ruined, as a miracle. Abu Talha radiallahu anh was one of the 10 Muhajir Sahabas who were granted heaven while alive.